Okay, now this is a fun thing. I have not addressed it before in any of my yogis. I've not gone that way. I have not discussed the Chinese astrology. And when I say Chinese astrology, I mean today is the year of the dog time. We have year of the dog the entire year. And this happens more around this time, February, that it changes over. So here we are, and I'm like, well, yes. And then I'm like, more and more, I start to see people differently now. And I'm really I'm feeling more and more attracted to its sentiment that there are so many rabbits, and there are so many cockerels, and there are so many oxens in my life that have existed and that I've known. And I'm like, well, that's an interesting group. Yeah. And here I am, a snake. Yeah. So, I'm a snake. I'm not a rat. I didn't get the adulations of being a gold rat. There is a gold rat, I know. And that's interesting, to be a gold rat. That's very unusual. Very unusual. And indeed, Mahatma Gandhi, interesting enough, was a snake. So I guess we are yogi snakes together in that likeness. We don't share the same element, though. We have different elements. Now we have wood. There's a wood element. There's an earth element. There is a metal element. There is fire. And there is gold. So you can have one of those elements associated with your particular animal. So you can be a gold rat, and that's hysterical to me that somebody would be a gold rat, and I actually know them. I kind of feel like honored just to have a gold rat in my repertoire of people. And I almost feel like I want to put them on a shelf, like they are so special and wonderful. And like to be treated as just like a god in a way. There is something about gold that is that pushy, isn't it? It wants you to treat it like a god. So here I am, and I'm like, well, my gosh, I'm just a lowly snake. And then I'm like, well, there's nothing wrong with this snake. However, when I was reading through it all, and all my moans and groans and my wonders, you know, where people are so sociable, and I'm yet to be that, and I'm never going to be that. And I'm like, well, if I'm not that sociable type, you know, is there something wrong with me? And then, heck no. I look it up, and there's the snake, and they're not supposed to be. They're not supposed to be these woo-woo, everybody get in a group, like a rabbit warren den. No, I'm not a rabbit warren den type. So there will be none of that going on. There will be just a lot of solitude, and that is fine. That's fine with the snake. So that's very interesting. So yes, and my mother, my dear mother, was an ox. She was a fire ox, which means very extroverted, and very extroverted type. So very interesting. I know two fires, very close, and they're very, very something about them. Yeah, something has been lit underneath them, literally. And yet, we're like, well, it's just a game. It's all just a game, you know. And then yet, I'm looking at all these people, and I'm going, well, no, this man really is a rabbit. And he's like a walking rabbit. And the more and more in his life, he's become more and more a rabbit. And that's why I'm like, well, maybe go vegetarian all the time, you know. Just, you know, doesn't seem right for rabbits to be eating meat, does it? It just doesn't. But here I am, snake, and what am I supposed to eat? Mice? I'm supposed to scarf a mouse hole. And what else? Come on. Yeah, they like mice. And they guess what else they eat? They eat rabbits. They strangle them. They wrap around them and they strangle them to slowly squeeze them to death, like those mambos and those boa constrictors in the jungle. Not all snakes do that. Habit. But it's an interesting thing to be a snake, and I wonder, you know, so I have to watch that habit that I don't overtake rabbit personalities. Rabbit personalities now are very, very precocious people. They're scared in a way. They are like timid, and they are very like, whoa, not sure. A lot of frozen in the headlights going on with the rabbits. So if you have a rabbit near you as dear to you, my gosh, we're going to have to treat them differently. And yeah, so I have 1, 2, 3 rabbits that I know of right away. And it's very interesting group. Because they all get along. They all get along with each other. There's no friction. There's no fighting. There's no aggressive moment. They're just all like clummy and like too nice to each other in a way. And I'm like, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? And it's just like, well, maybe they're just rabbits. And we'll leave it at that. So now I'm starting to understand them more and more and more. You know, their personalities are gelling closer to their Chinese astrology. So when I'm looking now at my distance, my own particular distance from the world and society, to look at it from a larger space, the snake personality element has helped me, and it has been a force. So absolutely, it has been great. It has been a great base, a great foundation for me in particular. And although it is also one that's highly criticized, the snakes are highly criticized because they are antisocial. They are often antisocial types. They are not gregarious in, hey, let's go out and party every night. They're not this type. They are more sequestered away. So, now, let's go away from the snakes. We have, okay, so I talked about the gold rat, you know, the great gold rat. Monkeys, now, I haven't looked up everybody, but they're, now, monkey type is interesting. The dog type is interesting also. Yeah, and then you look at the compatibilities of everybody. And I have a lot of cockerels that I know. Now, the cockerels, oddly, are not... when they talk about cockerels in their charts and everything, they don't actually seem to be like a regular cockerel in real life, but they say the cockerels are they're supposed to get along with snakes, but it's odd because also in the wild, the snake will strangle a cockerel if he comes across it. You know, if the snake is large enough. So yeah. So I wonder if that is another thing, you know. So what do we have next? We have the pig. Don't ever forget, we have the pig. And that doesn't necessarily mean a glutton, but yeah, we have all of these to look at. And it's very exciting, the animals. And you have to bring all of this back to zoology. This was at a time, these were made at a time before this was a food source, commercial world, where the animals were just raised in terrible barns for there to not even see light, just so humans can eat that in their mass grocery stores. No. These charts were made, these astrology signs and symbols were made when zoology was God, when the animals were gods. You know what I mean? They still are gods to people. So we look at all of them a different way. Now there's the dragon. The dragon actually was alive many times back in the past. There were dragons. There were sea dragons, sea serpents, and many of them supposedly walked on land. So yes, there were dragons. Now, oddly, they did not have a fish. There's no fish. There is no how shall I say it? Oh, I forgot water. I did forget water also. I'm sorry. We have fire, water, earth, metal, gold, and wood. I did forget the water. There is, you can be in an animal associated with the water also. And yes, so interesting, yeah. So you could be a water oxen. That's an interesting one. You can be a water boar. Yeah, so very, very odd, one would think, you know, why would an oxen or why would a boar be in standing water or want to be in the water? It's just the way it goes. They are associated with that, and so the element of water really, really takes a play into who they are. So next we are at, do not forget, I'm not done with all of them. Come on, I don't even have the charts in front of me, and I know there's about 12. Okay, we have the monkey, we have the rat, we have the cockerel, we have the snake, we have the rabbit, we have the boar, wild pig, we have the oxen, and I am out, the dragon. Okay, I'm out a few animals here. What's going on? Oh gosh. Yeah, I feel limited. I'm out a few animals. Oh, the horse. Yes, we have the horse. Yeah, the horse animal. That's an unusual. I don't think I know any horses. So when you look at the close people that you know that you're friends with or your relatives with, and then frictions that you have with them or distances that you have with them, or similarities, and hey, we get along and there's not a problem. You know, maybe you guys are. It's not necessarily that you're the same animal getting along either, because oftentimes you know you can't say two snakes get along. You would say maybe it has to be like a snake and something else, you know what I mean? So I'm missing a few more animals in that list, and I feel really bad. I've forgotten a few. But yeah, they created all kinds, and they still, I don't know, they still do maybe, these round circles, similar to the Stonehenge thing, but round circles where the animals are just like totems, and they're statues all the way around, just like a chart. And when I say a chart, a sun chart, a solar chart. So they set it up so the sun, the moon, the stars, everything just goes around and points at different animals at times. So I mean, they were different, clever, weren't they? And they really, 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 it wasn't about hunting these animals. It was about the personality self that you are that is that animal. And it is very, very interesting. Very interesting to me. Gosh, who did I forget? There's no guinea pigs. There's no mice. They don't use mice. There is a tiger. Hello. I don't get along with tigers, but anyway, there are tigers. I did forget the tiger. Oh my gosh, I should go out there and hunt them down, shouldn't I, for the Exactamundo? I know it. I can't stand it. The Chinese animals. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Well, what animal am I, they all say. Yeah, and there they are, 12. The 12 zodiacs. Who did I forget? The goat. That's it. I had everybody except the goat. Okay. Don't get your goat. Yeah. So it's not don't get your goat. It has nothing to do with how we are in Western world and our sayings. You know, it's nothing to do with that. You really need to look it up. Now, when I want to talk about, though, that is kind of frightening and scary, ooh, and precautious like a rabbit, is they have the numbers. They have lucky numbers. These animals have lucky numbers, and they have unlucky numbers. And I'm like, this is not possible. I can't stand it. Because the unlucky numbers are in our telephones. The lucky numbers are also in our telephones. And I'm like, well, darn it. Now I want to change my phone number. I want to change my address. I'm not in a lucky house necessarily. I'm just in an okay house. And as I said, not good enough, is it? And so so now I'm more and more getting excited and thrilled and filled with all of this diehard love for the animal charts. Now the lucky numbers are not swaying in my direction, and I feel cheated. Now I want to switch everything around. Switch everything. Lucky numbers, and I even have lucky plants. I have certain flowers, and I love them. I love them for doing that. I think that's wonderful. When you look at the regular, you're a Sagittarius or Capricorn. I don't know. These are much funner. Poor little pig. Yeah, there he is, the poor little pig. He gets a lot of, are you a pig, it says. This is a great site. It's called ChinaHighlights.com. And oh my gosh. And you could be, oh my gosh, the pigs are impatient, it says. Sometimes they're impatient and irritable. Oh my gosh. Oh, you could be a water pig. Now, a water pig is funny. Gentle, modest, earnest, responsible, but subjective in life. I mean, isn't that beautiful that somebody has that for you? In a way, it's like, you know, when you're lost and you need a path, and you're like, well, wait a minute. Maybe that really is me. I mean, there is absolutely nothing wrong with Chinese astrology. I think it's phenomenal. It's phenomenal. And that it is this precise, that it goes to this person, it goes to that person. Now, you know, there are other things, of course, that they try to shoot off at you and say, but wait a minute, you were just at that, it's not just that year, it's when you were born during that year, the time, and maybe your planet was in retrograde at the same moment. And of course, all of those things can change or alter. Oh, my good heavens. An earth pig has a strong sense of timekeeping. Good, and they're popular with their friends, and they're communicative. So if you're an earth pig, then go for it. So here we are. We're, you're very sociable. A timekeeper. So it's 5 o'clock? I guess so. We have the wood pig, the fire pig, the earth pig, the gold pig, and the water pig. So, wood, fire, earth, gold, water. Oh my gosh. And this site even tells you who was famous. We have the fire pig of Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yay! Go him. And a lot of pigs here. We have fire pig Hillary Clinton. We have water pig of Henry Ford. Now, that's pretty unusual. Now, I think when they say Henry Ford, they're referring to the car company guy? Yeah, 1863, the car inventor. Now, Ronald Reagan is a gold pig. So here we have a lot of politicians. That's unusual. They're not always politicians. I believe the Oxen, one of the Oxen is a Van Gogh, Vincent Van Gogh. So if you were an Oxen, you have a chance of being a Vincent Van Gogh type. So that's very interesting. Yeah, so look up this site and just have fun with it. It's called ChinaHighlights.com. I love them. They're wonderful. Okay, and that's it. That's all I have for today. And, ooh, I'm a snake. Watch out.